When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, the time shall be no more. And the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the seven arch shall gather over on the other shore, and the rolling call of yonder, I'll be there. When the rolling call of yonder, when the rolling call of yonder, when the rolling call of yonder, call up yonder, I'll be there. On the bright and coldest morning, and the bride in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share. And the closing arms are gathered to their home beyond the sky, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll labor for the master from the dawn he set his son. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. When the all in life is over and our walk on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, happy. When the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, happy day. When the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. Glory be to God in the highest. Amen.
Amen.
Glory must be to the Lord.
To the Lord.
God, great is your name.
Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Father.
For you are higher than us, for counting us among the living, for your protection throughout the week. Lord, as we are gathered in your presence, Father, we want to hear from you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So, Father, speak to our hearts, speak to our minds, speak to our thoughts this morning. Speak to our, oh Lord, Father, life, oh Lord, Father, that we, our life will be fruitful, my God, Father, to glorify your holy name. Have your way, oh Lord, Father, in this garden. Holy Spirit, take absolute control, my God, Father.
Amen.
Give us wisdom and revelational knowledge of your word and the understanding of it this morning in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we commit the atmosphere, we commit all over this territorial, all over that territory, my God, into your able sense, and we pray that you arrest every spirit of distraction, every spirit of buying and selling, every spiritual territorial powers, my God, that govern the affair of this environment. Lord, we command it to be arrested and be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Holy Spirit of the living God, take absolute control.
Amen.
Let our flesh decrease and let your Holy Spirit increase in us this morning in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, I present myself as a vessel, oh my God, Father, unto you, oh Lord, Father. Lord, use me, oh Lord, Father, to speak to your children today, my God, Father. Give us, give me utterances of your word, oh Lord, Father, and understand you, my God, Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Take absolute control, Lord, Father. Lord, speak through me, oh Lord, Father, to deliver your word, oh Lord, Father, Lord, and let every soul here today be blessed through your word in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Take absolute control, Father, in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus' name.
Blessed be Jesus.
Let us be seated. You are all welcome in the name of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So I'm happy to be here in the presence of the Lord. I want to hear you shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Our title today is called The Fruitless Tree. The fruitless tree, and our Bible, our memory verse will be taken in the book of John 15, John 15:16. Praise the Lord. Let us open our Bible in the book of John 15:16. And anybody that is there, please kindly read to us. John, yeah?
You did not choose me, but I chose you.
Amen.
And appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain.
Amen.
So whatever you ask in the ask the Father in my name, he may give it.
He will give it unto us. Praise the Lord. This is our memory verse that will be taken from the text today in the name of Jesus. We are talking about our title today is Fruitless Tree. And the memory verse make you understand that the Bible says in the book of John 15, verse 16, it said, you did not choose me, but I choose you, and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So this is the that's not where we are taking our text to, but we'll come back to it. But it's our memory verse. Then now let us go to the book of Luke 13. To the book of Luke 13. We're gonna read from verses 6-9. Luke 13. We want to see that the story of the fruitless tree. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Luke 13 from verse 6. From verse 6-9.
He also spoke this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard.
Praise the Lord. Is everybody there? Hold on. Is everybody there? Okay. Okay, read on, ma'am.
And he came seeking fruit on it and found none. Then he said to the keeper of the vineyard, look, for 3 years I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree and find none. But cut it down, why does it use up the ground? But he answered and said to him, sir, let it alone this year also, until I dig around it and fertilize it. And if it bears fruit, well, but if not, after that you can cut it down.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So here our Lord Jesus Christ give us the story of a fruitless tree. Praise the Lord. So we all understand that a fruitless tree is a tree that does not bring forth fruit. Amen. That does not bring forth fruit. So here our Lord Jesus Christ is trying to pass a message to us here. And very soon, we will understand what our Lord Jesus Christ meant here about the fruitless tree. So I just want us to take a scenario of a tree. When you plant a tree, it can be any tree. It can be a tree of mango, it can be a tree of apple, it can be a tree of oranges. So this tree, when it produces the fruit, then that tree become fruitful. Praise the Lord. Right. Just like a woman that give birth to children. They said the woman is fruitful. But when you do not give birth to a children, they will say the woman is barren. Praise the Lord. Right. So here, I want us to see the story and so that we can understand it very well. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the one speaking here. Because every red letter in the Bible is the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. In verse 6, he said, he also spoke this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came seeking fruit on it and found none. Then he said to the keeper of his vineyard, look, for three years I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree and find none. Cut it down. Why does it use up the ground? 8. But he answered and said to him, sir, let it alone this year also, until I dig ground it and fertilize it. 9. And if it bears fruit, well. But if not, after that you can cut it off. Praise the Lord. So our Lord Jesus Christ here, he was giving a scenario, he gave us a parable of a fig tree. A tree that was 3 years planted there for many years, for 3 good years, and that tree was not giving forth fruit. Then our Lord Jesus Christ wanted to eat fruit from that tree. And he tried to get a fruit, he did not see anything. So he said, why this tree is just there? That is not producing anything. Therefore, let us cut it down. He commanded the vine dresser of the tree to cut it down. Then the vine dresser said, please, sir, let us give it some years. Let us give it some more time that will fertilize and take care of it. Then we'll see after some times if it did not give fruit, then we can cut it up. But if it gives fruit, praise the Lord. So why am I taking this story here? The same way also we children of God. When you look at the story here, the tree is we, the children of God. We represent the tree. Then it's God that was speaking here. Then the vine dresser was our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Amen. So, as we also children of God, the Bible makes us understand that if we do not produce fruit, so fruit is the beauty of the tree. Fruit is what the tree produce, bring forth. Praise the Lord. I want you to understand the meaning of tree here. Tree is the fruit, the beauty that represents the tree that represents the beauty of the fruit. Praise the Lord. So what come out of the tree, that is what represents the beauty, the glory of the fruit. Praise the Lord. When the fruit is planted and is flourishing, you will see the fruit, the beauty that will come out of that tree. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So we'll still go more deeper to more understanding. Let us open again our Bible in the book of John 15. John 15 from verse 1 to 6. Praise the Lord.
I am the true vine and my Father is the vine dresser.
Make sure everybody is there. Is everybody there? Amen. Read it again.
1 to 6.
John 15, from 1 to 6.
I am the true vine, and my Father is a vine dresser.
Yes.
Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word which I have spoken to you.
Yes.
Abide in me, and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit for itself, unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and throw them into the fire and they are burned.
Amen. Praise the Lord. There in this book of John 15, he really explained to us who are who is the tree. And also, if you are not productive, you're gonna cut us away and we'll be burned into fire. Praise the Lord. I pray this morning that we'll not be burned into fire in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Just like I was saying, that Jesus Christ gave a parable of a fig tree, a tree that does not produce fruit. I just wanted to make us understand that we are children of God. We are the planting of the Lord. Our Lord Jesus Christ has come to give us hope, to set us free from the grip of the devil. Now, when Jesus Christ has set us free, we need to be productive. Praise the Lord. The fruit are the products that come out, the image of Christ in us, because we are his image on earth. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So as the tree here, the Bible says in the book of John 15, he said, I am the tree. I am the true vine. And my Father is the vine dresser. This is our Lord Jesus Christ again, saying again his word. And he said, every branch in me that does not bear fruit is taken away. So our Lord Jesus Christ is talking about, telling us here, that we are the branches. And any branch that is not bearing fruit, we see that, you know, when you see a tree that is planted and it does not produce, that tree, before you know, maybe the owner will say, you, this tree, you are not producing, let us just call it away. Because he fertilized it, he did everything he can do, and the tree is not productive. So therefore, as children of God, when we are not productive on earth, because we are being assigned, we didn't just appear on earth here for fun or to just have a good life, to just, you know, acquire whatever we want to acquire on earth here and go away. No, we came into this world for a purpose. So when that purpose is not fulfilled, then there is no reason for us to be where we are. Amen. So our Lord Jesus Christ is telling us that he said, any branch in me, which means that anyone that comes from him, anyone that represents the image of Christ, anyone that have his image in him, he said, if that person does not bear fruit, he will be cut away. And every branch that bear fruit, he prunes that it may be bear more fruit. You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So our Lord Jesus is reminding us here again, as children of God, that he said anyone, every child of God that comes from Christ, every child of God that is born again, that goes to church, that's called himself Christian, and he does not bear fruit, he says such person will be cut away. Now, today is Sunday, isn't it? When you go all over the world, you will see churches full. You will see people gather in the house of God, you know, singing, praising God, praising God. But how many of them are being productive? Praise the Lord. How many of them are being productive? That's what the Jesus Christ said. I say, it's not everyone that say, Lord, Lord, to me, that will enter the kingdom of God, but those that does that the will of my Father. So what I'm trying, what our Lord Jesus Christ is making to understand that if we do not produce, if we do not bear fruit, that he will gonna cast us, cut us away. Praise the Lord. And I proceed, verse 4, he said, abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit on its own. Praise the Lord. The branch cannot bear fruit on its own except it needs the vine dresser. Praise the Lord. So he said that a branch cannot bear fruit on its on fruit of its own, of itself, unless he abides in the vine. Whether can you unless you abide in me? 5, he said, I am the vine, you are the branches. Now he's telling us who we are here. And he said, he who abides in me and I in him bear much fruit. For without me you can do nothing. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So here our Lord Jesus is reminding us again here. You know, he gave us a parable of a tree. So if that tree is not being productive, it will be cut. That is a physical tree, you know, that we can see that produce fruit. Now we are representing tree now as children of God. So he now said that without him, we can do nothing. So which means that in our home, we cannot produce fruit. That's why our Lord Jesus Christ tell us in his word that, you know, there is no perfect person or good person except he that is in Christ. If you are not in Christ, if the image of Christ is not in you, there is no way you can bear fruit on his home. Praise the Lord. Then you can tell me that, what about people that do not know Christ? They are good, they do charity, they are rich, they are doing well. Even the Bible said that, what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? So which means that without Christ, such person, you can acquire everything here on earth here, but such person might not make heaven. Why? Because he's not in Christ. There are some certain life that a child of God has to live when you have Christ in you that will give you victory here on earth and also everlasting life. So if you are not in Christ, you cannot do it on your own. Praise the Lord. So I just said, as I said, the branch cannot do it on its own except it's within Christ. Except is in Christ. Praise the Lord. And 6 now says, if anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and throw them into the fire, and they are burned. Praise the Lord. Will not be burned in Jesus' name. So what am I saying here? That we are the branches. We are the fig tree that the Lord God has planted in this world. We need to be productive. Our life needs to be productive because we have the image of Christ in us. Praise the Lord. Now, I quickly go, what are the fruit now that, you know, the Bible is talking about here? The fruit that he's talking about, that is not the fruit for you to acquire blessing on earth. It's not the fruit for you to do charity or to preach the gospel. No. Praise the Lord. The life that you live, what come out of you, the image of Christ that is in you, what come out of it? Praise the Lord. Because many people today, everybody can say is born again, isn't it? When you ask anybody, are you born again? In fact, anybody that goes to church is born again. Praise the Lord. But the real born again, for you to know who is really born again is by their fruit. The Bible says that by their fruit you shall know them. Amen.
Amen.
By their fruit you shall know them.
Amen.
So if anyone is in Christ, have the image of Christ in him, the life had to produce fruit. Those are the fruit that Jesus Christ is talking about. When Jesus Christ was passing, he saw a fig tree. The fig tree was not productive. It was just there. It was not productive. Nothing good was coming out from the fig tree. Then Jesus Christ said, in that case, let this tree be cut away. There is no point for you to occupy the earth there and the ground there and just be useless like that. No. Let us cut it away. And at the same way that our Lord Jesus Christ is sitting on the right side of our Heavenly Father, begging for us, this is what he's doing every day. So now Jesus Christ is begging, saying, no, Father, do not let him cut it away. Let us give him a time. After some years, after some time, let us, you know, decorate it. Let us, you know, pour water, fertilize it and everything. And you will see, after some time, if the tree does not produce anything, then we can call it away. But if it produces, glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So what are we saying here? That we are the planting of the Lord. The Lord God has created us for a purpose. We are his children. We came from him. So when we are his children, we need to produce. We need to show the image of Christ in us. Amen?
Amen.
We need to be fruitful. Our life needs to be fruitful. Because nowadays, just like I said, everybody that goes to church is a Christian. Everybody that goes to church is a born again. When you ask my sister, are you in class? Ah, I am a born again Christian. You know, the born again now has become, you know, like a national item. It doesn't really move anybody anymore. But how are you going to know if this person is a child of God? It's by the fruit that such person, such Christian is producing. So those are the fruit that the Bible is telling us today. Amen.
Amen.
So what are the fruits? Let us open our Bible in the book of Galatians 5 so that we can see the fruit that the Bible is talking about here. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Galatians 5. Amen. Are we all there? Galatians 5.
Now the works.
Yes, sir.
So, but if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are evident, which are adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lewdness, idolatry, sorcery, hatred, contentions, jealousies, outbursts of wrath, selfish ambition, dissensions, heresies, envy, murderer, drunkenness, reveries, and the like, of which I tell you beforehand, just as I have also told you in the time past, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Verse 22.
Yes.
But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy,
yes,
peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such, there is no law.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So these are the fruit that the Bible is telling us about. Amen. So, like I said, what are the fruits? The book of Galatians 5 from verse 19, he explained to us here. So from 19 to 21, he's telling us the fruit of the flesh. When you are living in the flesh, you also produce fruit. So those fruit of the flesh, they are all what the Bible says in the book of Galatians 5 from verse 19. So all such person that practice all those kind of fruit, they cannot make heaven. They cannot enter the kingdom of God. Like I said, the Bible says, by their fruit, you shall know them. The fruit is not about you doing charity. It's not about you, you know, sharing your food to somebody. No. But as a child of God that had the image of Christ in him, so the fruit of Christ, which is living in him, will now begin to manifest. And this one is the fruit of the flesh. Why? Because some person is living in flesh. So when you are living in flesh, then you will reap the flesh. You will reap corruption. You will reap such, you know, atrocity, the sin that will begin to produce outside. Praise the Lord. And remember, the Bible, Jesus said that if this fruit does not produce anything, let it be cut it. Cut it away and let it be burned into fire. Amen. So which means that a child of God that has the image of Christ does not produce the spirit, the fruit of the spirit. It does not produce, because if it does not produce the fruit of the spirit, it will produce the fruit of the flesh. Then now verse 22 now explain to us, what are the fruit of the spirit here? Then the fruit of the spirit said, love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So those are the fruit that the Bible is talking about here. Amen.
Amen.
And such fruit, you cannot just produce such fruit on your own. Hallelujah. You cannot do it on your own. No matter how somebody is nice, it will get to a point that nice will stop somewhere. We all know what I'm talking about. When you are nice man, and people take your niceness for granted, you will stop one day to say, enough, I've done much for this person. But when Christ is in you, you will not stop. You will not stop. You will continue. Why? Because the image of Christ is in you. He has empowered you, because you cannot do it on your own self. On your own self, you have limits. When you have done something for somebody, the least is 3 times. More than that, that is it. But when the image of Christ is in you, when the fruit or the spirit of Christ is living in you, you will not have enough. Though it's, as a human being, it will pain you a bit, as in the flesh, that I am doing for this person. I am doing for how many years I will take care of this person, and it's not changing. It's not improving. But you will keep on going. Keep on going. Why? Because the Lord will strengthen you. The Lord will empower you to keep on going. Don't stop. Don't give up. Keep on going. Amen.
Amen.
So, because of time, we cannot go to break down one by one what are those fruit is talking about. But what I'm trying to say here, that our Lord Jesus Christ is talking about fruit here. And the fruit is what we produce from inside through the image of Christ. So this fruit, we cannot do it without Christ. That is the reason why every human being on earth needs Christ. We cannot do without Christ, because it's from him we came from. We are planting of the Lord on earth. And if we do not produce, it's just like you are, you know, it's just like you take a flower, you are beautifying it, you know, arranging it every day, pouring water, and the flower is not growing. What are you going to do? You're going to pull it out and throw it away. It's useless. The purpose of planting a tree is for that tree to produce fruit, isn't it?
Yeah.
It can be apple, it can be oranges, but if you are planting it and you are doing, you fertilize, you do everything and it's not producing, what are you going to do? At the end of the day, you cut it off, because you're wasting your time. Praise the Lord. The same way also we are to Christ. If you come into this earth and we are hearing the gospel every day, and message, we are hearing messages, preachers are going around preaching the gospel, we are hearing it and we are not changing, I pray that the Lord God Jesus Christ will not cast us away. Because one, whether we like it or not, one day he's coming back, and he's coming back to take away all those that have been fruitful, all those that have been planted on earth here and doing his work faithfully, in joy, in peace, producing the fruit of the spirit outside. You see, nowadays, people do not carry, they don't read Bible. If you want preach tomorrow, they don't read Bible anymore. But our life, that is what they are looking at. When you come, you say you are born again. I want to see that born again. Praise the Lord. I used to have an uncle like that in my father's house. The man will come, the way he lives his life, in fact, it's like Christ is always in his mouth, but the character does not show. Any small thing will get angry. And that time I was not born again, I will not say, you go to church and you get angry like this. He will say, so if I go to church, I should be a fool. So I should not talk again. That's why people to be doing anything. That time I didn't understand Christianity, so I was just looking at it. But now I understand better. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So people are not reading the Bible. Nobody has time. I believe even most of what that are here now, nobody during the week take Bible to say, okay, let me just take the Bible and read on my own. But until on Sunday, when we come, when pastor say, open the Bible, open this other, then we'll read. So, but how we will know that this person is trying to go? When you look at the life of the person, because you cannot read the Bible and live differently. That is a fruitless person. you read the Bible, you go to church, you pray. At the end of the day, your character does not show any image of Christ. That is a fruitless person. So the fruit that the Bible is talking about, that your character, your behavior, as you are confessing Christ, is it the way your life is? There is a scripture in the Bible that says that if you are telling people don't steal, do you steal yourself? If you tell somebody don't lie, do you lie yourself? If you say somebody don't fornicate, do you fornicate yourself? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So our lifestyle, our attitude, our behavior, the way we act to things, our reaction to things, don't misunderstand me. We are human. You know, sometimes people will do things to you as a human, you know, that will make you react. Of course, you can get angry, but the Bible says don't sin. In your getting angry, don't sin. Let the person know that this thing that you have done, I don't like it. This is the way, that's not the way to talk. You know, we need to be patient. Let us give time to people. This patience also is one of the fruits. Long suffering. Praise the Lord. We need to be patient. Those are the fruit that we have to produce. And when we don't do that, it's just like we are just planted for nothing. We are not useful to our Lord Jesus Christ. What is the answer to go to church? Because one day he's coming to take all the children of God that are be fruitful, that are, you know, faithful, and living the life and the image of Christ. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So let us go back to our Luke 13. Our Luke 13, that is where we'll round up. Amen. Luke 13, from verse, let's read Luke 13, 6-9.
He also spoke this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in the vineyard, and he came seeking fruit on it and found none. Then he said to the keeper of this vineyard, "Look, for 3 years I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree and find none. Cut it down. Why does it use up the ground?" But he answered and said to him, "Sir, let it alone this year also, until I dig around it and fertilize it. And if it bear fruit, well. But if it does not bear fruit, If not, after that, you can cut it down."
Amen.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ is a merciful Father. He's so merciful. Many of us, just like he has said here, he tell the Father, he said, "Please, sir, let us not cut it off. Let us wait a little bit. He will fertilize it. He will take care of it. He will do whatever he can." Just like what is happening to some of us, many of us all over the world, we are hearing the gospel. Now today is not only Bible. You can even have Bible in the audio. TV is there. Radio is there. We have iPad. We have every electronics stuff. You can download Bible. Whatever you want, which means that there is many avenues that Lord Jesus Christ is taking to pass the message. Pass the message. If you don't come to church, the one that is not coming to church, even those people that you see on the street, they will see tracks. Some Christians will go to them and give them tracts. So there is many ways that our Lord Jesus Christ is trying to fertilize us. He said, "Lord, please, sir, let us give it time. After some time, if it's not productive, then you can call it away." So our Lord Jesus Christ is pleading for us. Many of us is waiting. Okay, next year, next month, next week, she will give her life to Jesus. He will give her life to Jesus. "Sir, don't come now. Don't let me come now. I die for these people." Our Lord Jesus Christ is pleading for us every day. But for how long is going to continue like that? Praise the Lord. So here he's telling us that he has given us time. He's keeping giving us time that we should prepare ourselves. He's giving us time, pleading for us. We can see all what is happening all over the world. And when you look at all the things that are happening, our Lord Jesus Christ is, the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ is near. It's very, very near. Recently, I received a message, and somebody was saying that she was in the bathroom, and she just, you know, God just spoke to her that she should tell the people of God, they should get ready, they should prepare, that is a shaking coming. Praise the Lord. And people have been saying that she's not the first person that is saying that. People have been saying that. Some people see some sign. Things are coming. But how long those things are going to be? I think when you see those kind of things, our Lord Jesus Christ is still, he loves us. He don't want us to perish. He's giving us time. He's giving us signs that his coming is near. We need to prepare ourselves. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We need to work out our salvation with fear and trembling. Let us get ready in any way we can. Let us start from somewhere. At least we are getting, because on that day, nobody will give an excuse to say, "No, yes, sir." That nobody share me track. I didn't hear in the TV. No, there is no excuse. No excuse. Because he making every avenue possible for us to hear the gospel, for us to come to him, for us to be fruitful, for us so that he will not be cast away on it. Because on the day is coming, there is no mercy. There is no say, "Please, sir, just give me 1 minute or 1 year. No, when he comes, that is the end. So please let us not wait. Just like he said that there is no repentance in the grave. When somebody is dying, is finished. That is the end of that person. So please, my brother and sister, I beseech you, you and I, let us be fruitful. Our character, our attitude, let it, because that is our character that will draw people. Not you carrying Bible. Just like I know some sister in Ireland, they will carry Bible or they will take these boxes and write on it, "Jesus Christ is coming soon. Repent. John 3:16. For God, they will put it at the front, at the back, even to their children, and they will go in the street. After they finish, when they come back home, they will be insulting themselves. They will be fighting. Every time will be sorting matter. Which kind of believer is that? So because of that attitude, now even where they are living, when they preach the gospel, people don't listen to them. At the end of the day, they have to move out from that place. Praise the Lord. So what I'm telling you is that your character is not what you put on. It's good. I'm not saying that it's not good, though, for you to go and preach the gospel and write here, "Jesus is Lord." There is no bad thing. But when you are doing that, work on yourself. Work on yourself. Let the fruit of that "Jesus is Lord" come out. So when that fruit come out, then you are preached more. You will preach more. You will not even make more effort, and you will see people coming. People will come and ask you, "But your life is different. What makes you different? What is your secret?" Then you will say, "It's Jesus." Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That is how you can be fruitful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then let's go. Lastly, let's go to John 15:16. That is where we will stop. We will end. John 15:16. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
"You did not choose me, but I chose you. And appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain. That whatever you ask your Father in my name, you
may do." Amen. In the book of John 15:16, he said, "You did not choose me, but I chose you, and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you." Now, I want to back that scripture up with Romans 8:28. Romans 8:28, you will know what our Lord to understand better when he said we do not choose ourselves, that he chose us. Amen. Romans 8:28-29.
"And we will know that all things work together for good to those who love God and to those who are the called according to his purpose."
Yes.
"For whom he foreknew," 29.
Yes.
"For whom he foreknew, he also predestined."
Yes.
"To be conformed."
Yes.
"To the image."
Amen.
"Of his son." "That he might be the firstborn among many brethren."
Amen.
Moreover,
yes,
"whom he predestined, this he also called." "Whom he called, this he also justified."
Yes.
"And whom he justified, this he also glorified."
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. So you see here, this passage is very clear. Like if somebody says, he said here that you did not choose yourself. You did not choose yourself to come to this world, isn't it? God permitted it. And he chose it to say, "Go and bear fruit, that your fruit will remain." Then here in Romans 8:28-30, now says, let me read from 29. He said, "For whom he foreknew." So which means that he knew you before you were even conceived in your mother's womb. Hallelujah. So before your mother had a plan to even bring you to this world, God knew you. He knew you. You come from him. Then he now say that he also predestined to be conformed to the image of God. So he predestined you. So he knew you and he brought you to this world to be conformed into the image of the Son of God. Praise the Lord. Then 13 now say, moreover, whom he predestined, this he also called. So as he has also brought you, he predestined you, he has programmed your destiny for you to come to this earth and bear fruit. And also as he brought you to this world, he also called you for an assignment. He called you. As he has called you, he called you for to be fruitful. He called you to go into the world and bring soul to him. Praise the Lord. Preach his gospel. Be fruitful. Amen. And so whom also he called also, whom also he called, this he called and he justified. Praise the Lord. So he has justified you. And also him we justify, this he also glorified. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just like we are saying, the fruit of a tree is the glory of the tree. So as you are also fruitful in life, the glory of God will begin to radiate upon your life. You are bringing glory of God forth. Praise the Lord. So he said he did not call yourself, but he called you to go and bear fruit, and your fruit, they will remain, they will stand. Praise the Lord. So when your life is fruitful, nothing will happen to you. When your life is fruitful, then you can open your mouth and take authority. Then you can open your mouth and decree. There is no power that can stand before you. Praise the Lord. He said, surely they will come, but they will not come near you. Why? Because such life is fruitful. And that fruit is being remained. Amen. So he said, go and be fruitful, and your fruit will remain. Then whatever you ask in his name, it shall be given unto you. My brothers and sisters, let us go out there and be fruitful. Let us show the image of Christ. Enough of, playing. Because what of most of we Christian believers are doing is we are playing. And that is the reason why you see people, even our life cannot affect our neighbor. Our life cannot bring people soul to church. We see in the time of the disciples, when the Holy Ghost fall upon them, when their life was transformed, the whole village, the whole town knew that these people are different. That is where the name Christianity came from. Because they see the image of Christ in them. They see their life be fruitful. They see love. They see kindness, patience, long-suffering, perseverance in their life. So therefore, they just did little. Open their mouth and speak, and people follow them. Amen.
Amen.
So also, those people, we are not different from them. They are the same people. They are those same people also. They are flesh and blood like us. So when we proclaim that we are children of God, our character matters. Our behavior, attitude. You know, sometimes, especially our children here, when you tell them, a child of God don't do that, they don't say, mommy, your Christianity, your own is too much. What is different? I will just play on it. I say, no. Because one does not belong to Jesus, he will not take it. When you know that you can go away from something, stop it. Because what you hear, what you do, what you hear, what you see, it matters. Because Jesus will not come and do this for us. We are the one. He said, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. So when you are a child of God, he has come, he has used the blood of Jesus Christ has used his blood to cleanse away all the sins that you have done, your previous done before you confess him. So for instance, the sin that you have committed last Monday to Saturday is gone when you receive Christ today. If you give your life to Christ today, genuinely, in the spirit, Jesus Christ will come, he will wipe away every sin. Because as you commit sin every day, it's being recorded. The power of darkness, they will be recording in their kingdom. So when you give your life to Jesus, Jesus Christ will come, he will use his blood and wipe it away. Then you start a new life. That's why we say born again. You were born through the blood of your parents, but now you are born in the spirit. You are born of the spirit. Then you start a new life in Christ Jesus. Then after today, everything that you do, it counts. Every single thing that you do, you count. So what you wash, what you do, everything is be recorded. So you need to wash away now and live the life of Christ. Praise the Lord. Amen. Then the life will begin to be fruitful. So please, I beseech you, my brothers and sisters, even including me that is speaking, let us go out there. Not just to preach the gospel. Please, I can stand there, talk morning to evening. But if my life is not fruitful, it's useless what I'm doing. That's why Jesus Christ said, it's not everyone that say, Lord, Lord, unto me that will enter the kingdom, but those that do the will of my Father. Why is he saying that? Because those preachers that are joyous, he let me say, ah, Lord, I have preached in your name. I have healed the sick. I have delivered, you know, people that are put on everything. Jesus saying, go away, I don't know you, workers of iniquity. Why is he saying that? Why is it that after all this work, great work, drawing soul to the kingdom of God, you know, healing the sick and everything, and Jesus will say, I don't know you. Because his life, he was not fruitful. The life of that leader or the pastor or the bishop was not fruitful. So I pray that our life will be fruitful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray that as we are going, as we are hearing the word of God every day, the Lord God will empower us. He will give us his grace. And his grace will enable us to do his will in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So he said, go and be fruitful. And let your fruit remain. Which means that that lifestyle, let it remain. Don't let it change. Don't let it change. Let it remain. Then anything you ask me, it shall be given unto you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God bless you as we have listened to this word. And I believe that the word will be really will be fruitful in our life. The word will really, you know, make us sit down and think about our own life. Many of us, we have been Christian for many years, you know, but we are not showing, we are not seeing the fruit. Let us work out on ourselves, because like I said, Christ will not come and do this for us. We ourselves need to do it. When you see things that is not okay with your spirit, at least we have a mind. We have a thought. When we do things, if it's not right, our mind will say, ah, this is not right. So let us work on it. Because it's those that are with Christ, those that are led by the Spirit of God, that are the sons of God. Those that are living the life of Christ, that are the children of God, and those are the people that he's coming for. Like I told my children, if Christ come now, if the Spirit is not, you know, testifying us that we are children of God, we cannot go upon all the work that you are doing. So all of us, we need to walk out of that salvation with fear and trembling. And the Lord will have mercy on us in Jesus' name. Let us rise on our feet. Praise the Lord. Let us rise on our feet.
Hallelujah.
I have no power of my own. I have no power of my own. I confess to you, Holy Spirit of God, I have no
before you.
Us to think deeply about this message today. When the Lord Jesus said we must be fruitful, we know that the fruit is the beauty of a tree. Just like a fruit of the womb is the beauty of a mother, of a woman that is married. If a woman marries and she does not have a baby, they say she's barren. And she becomes a talking subject of everybody. Even the family will fight the war so much that the husband will want to give up on his own wife, because she's not productive, she's not fruitful. So that is why they call babies, children, the fruit of the womb. And when we see a tree, what shows the beauty of a tree is the fruit of a tree. So, and the fruit of a tree comes from the nourishment that the tree has inside. In other words, the farmer put in time to put fertilizer, to put water, so that the tree can become fruitful. You see that? But it got to a point, this tree was not what? It was not producing anything. So the fruit is not different from the tree that brought forth the fruit. So this is what you must go home with today, with what our sister told us. And what is that fruit? The fruit is the image of Christ. Because he said in the book of John 15, he said, I am the vine and you are what? You are the branches. And from the branches come the fruit. So if Christ is truly in you, or if truly you are in Christ, you must produce his fruit. The fruit has been mistaken by many preachers, saying that, oh, the fruit is talking about is to preach the gospel, is to pay your tithes. That is not fruit. The fruit is to behave like the person that holds your vine. Jesus is the vine, and you are the branches that produce the fruit. Therefore, if you are truly in Christ, or if you are truly the branch of Christ, you must produce fruit after Christ. But if you are the branch of the world, you will produce what? The fruit after the world. It is just very simple. If you are living in the world, everything that you do is what they call fruit. The things you do is fruit of what your background is. It can't take me more than 5 minutes to discover whether somebody is a Christian or not by the time I see them. Because you will only show me what your background is. Some people used to say, oh, don't judge me by my dressing. I have Christ inside of me. It's true. And some of people dress very well too. They wear good skirt, good blouse, good scarf. And by the time they begin to behave, you will see that they don't have Christ in them. They think they have Christ, but they don't have understanding of Christ. So what are your fruit? The reason why God keeps you is because of your fruit. The reason why the devil is afraid of you is because of your fruit. And you see here, the Lord says, if you look one more year, if they don't start bearing fruit. There are many Christians in the church, they are not bearing fruit. God has been waiting. Give them one more year. Give them two more years. Maybe next year they become fruitful. Maybe their character will change. Maybe the way of the approach of things will change. Maybe the way they talk will change. Maybe the way they fight, they will reduce it. Maybe people will now begin to call you a child of God from next year. But they do what? They refuse. And guess what? It's not going to be like that forever. Very soon, the owner of the vineyard will send his angels to come and harvest. And what does that mean? Everyone that does not bear good fruit will not see Jesus in heaven. We have the fruit of the flesh. We have the fruit of the spirit. And the Bible says anyone that bear the fruit of the flesh, they will not inherit the kingdom of God. I want you to shout to God today as you pray this prayer. Oh Lord, my Father.
Oh Lord, my Father.
Have mercy on me, Lord.
Have mercy on me, Lord.
I want to begin to bear fruit after your kingdom.
I want to begin to bear fruit after your kingdom.
So that I can use my fruit to preach your gospel to every person in the world.
So that I can use my fruit to preach every gospel.
I don't want to disappoint you anymore.
I don't want to disappoint you.
I don't want to bring shame to you anymore. I want everybody to see your fruit in me.
I want everybody to see.
Begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Lord, I want to bear the fruit after you. I don't want to disappoint you anymore. I want to be a fruitful Christian. I want to use the fruit that I bear to preach your gospel. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I don't know whether it has happened to you before. It has happened to me before. When you go somewhere, they say, see this Christian. And he calls himself a Christian. Look at the way he behaves. Have you ever heard that before? Those are the Christians that don't bear fruit. Those are the Christians that fight and people say, hey, sister, it's okay now. Sister, leave my brother. Brother said, no, I will, let me give you a dirty slap so that I can know that Jesus Christ has resurrected. You want to use slap to tell somebody Jesus Christ resurrected? Some people say, let me show my anointing. I have anointing to slap. There's nothing like anointing to slap. We must be careful. We must show good fruit to all people. Let them see Christ in you. Let people see Christ in you. There's a song I want you to sing together with me as we close. You say, in me, is Christ that lives in me. I'm no longer the one that liveth, but Christ that lives in me. Says, I'm one. If you come this week, whatever you want to do, you ask yourself, can Jesus do this? Because I am a branch of Christ. I must bear his fruit. You know the reason why the church have problem today? Because Christians don't bear fruit anymore and they don't care. You know the reason why churches and preachers are being the way they speak today? I was watching a program of Nigeria yesterday on the TV. They were doing the Independent Day. And a governor was invited to speak. And they were talking that most of this stolen money from all the politicians, even the pastor too, they used to give them part of it. The preacher, they get part of the stolen money as gift. That when they steal the money, they give them. So everybody, that's why they don't see pastors. You cannot see them talking in Nigeria. They say, now say, go and consult men of God because they can sort our problem. No, they don't believe they can solve any problem. They believe they are thieves like them. So we must have fruit. Part of the fruit we have is that when somebody that is not born again, stole money, come and give you money, say, I'm sorry, I cannot take it. Because your life, I don't see your life change. How can I take gift from you? That's integrity. That's part of the gift of Christ. So as we close today, you say, Lord, lead me in your way. Teach me your path. Show me your way, Lord. Teach me, Father, what you want me to know. I don't want to be ordinary churchgoers. I don't want to be ordinary talkers of the Bible or talker of God. I want to bear fruit. Listen to me as I say this prayer. I want to think about it very well. Where does the fruit come from? It comes from fertilizer and the water that is being supplied to the tree. What is the fertilizer? As our sister said, the word of God that you hear every day. That's where you get your fruit from. The prayer meeting you go. The Bible study you go. The word that has been discussed there. If you don't put them into practice, you are not bearing fruit. You say, God help me, Lord, to be a doer of your word. Say that.
God, let me to be the doer of your word.
I want to be a doer of your word.
I want to be a doer of your word.
I don't want to be ordinary church goer.
I don't want to be ordinary church goer.
I don't want to be ordinary listener to the word.
I don't want to be ordinary listener to the word.
Transform me by the power of your word.
Transform me by the power of your word.
Grant me the understanding of your word.
Grant me understanding of your word.
In the name of Jesus. Re ema ali ma alika. Wa ima kose ke morobole ma alika ntanama. Re ema akanzaima kontem morobole ma alika ntanama. Zaima akanzaima kontem morobole ma. Make me the doer of your word.
Show me your way, teach me your way.
Establish me in your plan and purpose,
Lord.
Glorify yourself in me. Make me the bearer of your fruit, Lord. Not ordinary church goer, Lord. Transform me, body, spirit, and soul. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. So when, as from today, when somebody that is non-believer tell you, this is the way you are, don't fight back to say, whatever the Lord say, that I am, that it is, when people say what you are too, you have to correct it. It's not only God. Because I have heard that song before, when you say somebody is not behaving like Christ, say, I don't care whatever you call me. What God call me that is important. Whatever, did you hear God call you anything? Eh? How many times have you heard God call you a good boy? Or a good, how many people heard that? Say, God say, my good daughter. I mean, how many people have heard that before? So when woman be say you are a bad daughter, you better believe it. When they say you are a bad daughter of God or you are a bad son of God, you better believe them. Because God is speaking through them to you. And when you are good too, when they say you're a decent child of God too, they will tell you. So start working upon our faith, because that is the only way we can get prepared for heaven.
Amen.
The Lord will have mercy on us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Ancient of this, we give you glory.
Glory.
Merciful God, we praise your holy name. King of kings, I am that I am, we worship your majesty. We thank you for the souls that you brought today. We thank you for your daughter that you used mightily today. We thank you for the word that has blessed our souls so much and wonderfully. We pray, Lord Jesus, that this word will be part of our daily life, oh God. In the name of Jesus Nazareth, Lord.
Amen.
Lord, I commit your children to you as we go through this week. Let your presence go with us, Lord. This is a new month, a new week, Father. Lead us through this week and the rest of the years successfully in the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
Father, Lord, remove the snare of the fowlers and the trap of the hunters out of our way. Destroy them, Lord Jesus, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
Every Luciferian petition, satanic allegation, witchcraft accusation against any of your daughters or sons today, I cancel them with the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Nazareth, Lord.
Amen.
I speak into the sun, the moon, and the stars, and the heavens and the heart, and everything under the heart and all the planets,
yes,
the waters, the wind, and the white wind, and the animals that crawl or fly or walk, and the spirits that live inside human beings, the demons and all his agents, and the devil and herbalists. I speak to them today with the authority in the name of Jesus, to recognize you as a children of God.
Yes.
And I place the mark of God upon individual one of you, that they will not trouble you or your home or life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
I decree in the name of Jesus that no evil shall befall you.
Yes,
when the Lord commanded the children of Israel, he said, kill a lamb, kill lamb and put the blood at the door, at your doorpost. And when the angel of death pass through the land, they will pass over you. So I decree today that I place the mark of the Lord Jesus upon you today. And every trouble that is coming at the end of the year 2016, trouble, tribulation, death, sickness, and infirmity, they will not come to your house in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
They will not knock on your door in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will make them pass away from you in the name of Jesus, Nazareth.
Amen.
No evil shall befall you and your home. By the power in the blood of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
The water you drink and the food you eat, they will not work contrary to your body system. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
You will sleep in peace, for the Lord will grant you peace. And sleep in the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
You will wake up in glory and for God, for the Lord will grant your spirit life. For the spirit of the Lord God has made you, and the breath of the Lord has given you life.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
No evil bird or satanic snake or demonic cobwebs shall visit your home or body or spirit and soul. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
Father, we pray that you protect us, O Lord, Keep us in your secret place under your shadow for the rest part of this year, Lord. Glorify yourself in our lives.
Amen.
This is a special month of the kingdom of darkness, a month of their celebration, a month of their donation. We pray that anybody under my voice, including myself, you will not be used for donations into the kingdom of darkness or to their shrine or coven. In the name of Jesus Nazareth,
amen.
Your children will not be used for donations.
Amen.
Your husband or wife will not be used for donations.
Amen.
You will not die but live to declare the glory of God in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For you might have seen, Psalm 118 verse 17 and 18 says, you might have seen, but the Lord chastised you, which means the Lord punished you, but he did not hand you over to death. Therefore, I decree, you will not die, but live to declare the glory of God. In the name of Jesus Nazareth, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. In the name of Jesus, every mouth that rises against you, the Lord will condemn them to destruction. In the mighty name of Jesus Nazareth, so shall it be, Lord. We give you all glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
The grace altogether. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and love shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we will dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Three wonderful hallelujah.
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 The Lord is good.
All the time.
The Lord is good.